Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends. Up till now, in this subject, we have gone through the scalars, vectors, scalar field, vector field and three different coordinate systems, namely rectangular, cylindrical and spherical. Now, in electromagnetic field theory, we have the field vectors. So, upon going to calculate the values of these field vectors, we need the requirement of differential lengths, differential some surfaces and sometimes differential volume. So, let us begin with the topic. So, first of all, in rectangular coordinate system, we have the structure z-axis, y-axis and x-axis in three-dimensional space which intersect into the origin. Now, the three-dimensional space has three references x, y and z-axis. From this three-dimensional space, if I take out some sample volume outside for analysis purpose, it will look like this. So, for this three-dimensional object, if the dimensions are same, it will be a cube or else it will be a parallelepiped. So, it has length, breadth and height. Now, the edges of this particular object align either x-axis, y-axis or z-axis. So, the edges align to the x-axis are shown like this. So, from this corner, let us say, to this corner, the value of x is different. So, let us mark this to be x1, this to be x2. So, actually the length from x1 to x2 is the difference, which is x2 minus x1. So, let us denote this difference of length by dl, as the difference of length is on x-axis, we denote it dx. So, dx will be x2 minus x1. So, similarly, if you take the two corners in this cube for difference in y parameter, we shall denote dy is equal to y2 minus y1. And similarly, dz is equal to z2 minus z1. So, the dx, dy and dz represent differential lengths for the sample volume, sample object taken outside for rectangular coordinate system. So, in general, the differential length dl can be represented as dx ax cap plus dy ay cap plus dz az cap, as I have mentioned it with the help of ax cap, ay cap, az cap. The unit vectors ax cap, ay cap, az cap are in the increasing directions of x, y, z parameters. That is why, as this is the directed one, I should put bar over dl. So, this is the generalized differential length representation in rectangular coordinate system. So, the edges, I can denote this to be the dx, this to be the dz and this to be the dy. The parallel edges dy, dy, dy to this one. These are dz, dz, dz and this one dz. These are dx, dx, dx and dx. This is differential length. So, as the differential length is there, so it is a measure of distance. So, we always measure it in terms of meters. So, dl is having the unit meters m. Now, let us begin with the differential surfaces with respect to the representations of rectangular coordinate system. Now, for rectangular coordinate system having the axis x, y and z, we had this object and we denoted the vertical lines with dz, the horizontal lines with dy that are aligned to y-axis, and those aligned towards the x-axis, those we have denoted dx. Now, this object is having six surfaces, the top, bottom, two side walls, front and back side. So now each surface is like a rectangle, and we know that the area of the rectangle is nothing but length into breadth. So for each and every surface, there will be one length and one breadth option for us. So for six surfaces, let us write down the different lengths, which will in turn give us differential surface areas. Okay, so I denote the top to be the first one, so I write ds1. So top is formed by these kind of edges that are parallel and these kind of edges. So these edges are nothing but the ds, and this edge is the dy. So the area of the top surface we can obtain by the multiplication of dx and dy. Now for the bottom, again it will be the rule of dx and dy. So for bottom I write ds2, it is again dx and dy. For the side wall, this dimension is dz, whereas this dimension is dx. So the multiplication of dx with dz, so for ds3 left hand side sidewall, we write dx into dz. The opposite to that particular sidewall, that is right hand side sidewall, we have again dz and dx. So ds4 I write dx into dz. Now the front side, if I take, so it has this dimension dy and the vertical dimension dz. So ds5 is equal to dy into dz. Now the remaining side is the background, the back side, it is by dy and dz again. So ds6 is equal to dy into dz. Now if you focus some attention, so you will find that ds1 and ds2 are same for top and bottom, ds3 and ds4 are also same for the two side walls, and ds5 and ds6 are also same for the front and back side. Now the differential surfaces magnitudes only we have written. Okay, as we are in the electromagnetic field, everything is a vector here. So the vector differential surfaces should also be included with the directions. So now for such type of objects, the direction to the surfaces are always perpendicular to it. If it is the top surface, the perpendicular has two options, either going upward out of the box or going inward inside the box. For the bottom, again two options we have, either going upward inside the box or going outside, outward along the minus z sign. So which one to take? So for the sides which form this particular object, we have to always refer the outside direction. So for the top, we have to take upward. For the bottom, we have to take downward. For the sidewall on left hand side, I have to take left direction. For the sidewall on the right hand side, I have to take right direction. So this way, in terms of AX cap, AY cap and AZ cap, we will give the directions to ds1 to ds6, that are the differential surfaces. So for the top, the outward direction here will align towards the z axis, that is why this is az cap. So ds1 bar is nothing but dx dy into az cap, whereas the bottom will prefer the downwards to get outside. So this is along with minus az cap, so this become ds2 bar. Similarly for ds3, which is this side wall, the direction will be away, so that is towards the negative side of the y axis. This is minus ay cap, so this will be ay cap for this side wall. Now for ds5, so this becomes the vectors. ds5 is the front side constituted by dy and dz, so it will be along the x axis, so plus ax cap will be associated with, and the back side will be associated with minus ax cap. So here we come to how ds1 to ds6, the differential surfaces. One point you can note here that if the area of the particular surfaces is by multiplication of two parameters, for example x and y, the left one is z, which will give you the direction. If it has by dy and dz, the left parameter is x, that is not in the combination to determine the area. So we get the direction by the third vector, third unit vector. So these are the differential surfaces for rectangular coordinate system representation. So in general, the overall differential surface for the object will be the addition of these six differential surfaces. So ds bar is equal to dx dy az cap plus dx dy minus az cap plus dx dz minus ay cap plus dx dz ay cap plus dy dz ax cap plus dy dz minus ax cap. So this is the differential surface for rectangular coordinate system representation. Now let us go for what is the differential volume for rectangular coordinate system representation. So now differential volume we denote by dv. We always know that the area associated with the surface we get by the multiplication of length into breadth. The two dimensions, those form the edges of that particular surfaces. Whereas for volume, we have the multiplication of all the three dimensions, length into breadth into height. So for the object we had drawn here was like this. So it is having dx, dz and dy along the three length, breadth and height, you can say the dimensions of this particular object. These are the reference axis x, y and z in positive directions intersecting into the origin O. So the differential volume will be given by the multiplication of dx, dy and dz. So as the volume is there, multiplication of three lengths, the unit is meter cube. Volume does not have any particular direction. Increase into the volume or decrease into the volume generally happens in all possible directions. So dv, we don't put the bar over it, whereas for the ds we have written the bar. It has particular direction, and as these are the surfaces areas, multiplication of two dimensions, the unit will be meter square. Square meter will be the unit for each and every differential surface. Meter square. So we have seen the differential length, differential surfaces and differential volume associated with the representation of rectangular coordinates. Now let us again have differential length, surface and volume for cylindrical coordinate system. As we know, for cylindrical coordinate system we have only one reference, that is z axis. As in the case of rectangular there were three axes, we here have only one axis that I draw here. So this is z axis. So in cylindrical coordinate system we define the position, location of point, vector or now the object using only one reference, that is z axis, and the coordinates rho, phi and z. Rho, phi and z. So now the differentials will be denoted by d rho, d phi and dz. Okay. So now for analysis purpose, I take out sample portion of three-dimensional space in the three-dimensional cylindrical coordinate system model. So the differential space will be looking like this. So here you can consider this side of this particular object to be a part forming a cylinder around the z-axis, okay, having particular radius, suppose rho 1, and this side forms another cylindrical centered again along the z-axis with different length of radius rho 2. Here we can notice that rho 1 is larger than rho 2. Okay? So whatever the differential sample or the volume I have taken out for the analysis purpose, it is from the subtraction of smaller cylinder from the bigger cylinder. So for analysis purpose I redraw it. So see here, if this is the z axis, positive side, negative side, somewhere here there may be an origin. Okay. Now if we see the corners 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Out of these 8 corners, 1, 2, 3 and 4, these are a part of larger cylinder and these 4 are from a smaller cylinder. So if you want to get the value of radius, we shall draw a perpendicular onto the z-axis, okay, from each and every corner. So then we can come to know rho 1, rho 2 like that. So now if we switch from this corner to this corner, there becomes a change into the dimension. Okay. So the change into the coordinate, you can say. So that change is along the increasing direction of radius of the cylinder. So from this corner to this corner, I can say that we are moving from the space of smaller cylinder to the bigger cylinder. Hence, this line, this line, this line, this line, we are moving from smaller cylinder to bigger cylinder. That is why I write it to be d rho. So d rho, simply you can write, it is the difference into the rho. Rho we denote to the radius of the cylinder. So rho 2 minus rho 1 in general will be the d rho. Okay. So this line is also d rho, this line also d rho, this line also d rho, this line also d rho. For example, if the larger cylinder has the radius 2 units and the smaller cylinder has the length 2 units, so 4 minus 2, larger for 4 units, smaller for 2 units, 4 minus 2, all these lengths will be having 4 minus 2 equal to 2 units of length. But the directions are different. Here we are concerned with only the magnitude, that is represented by d rho. Now, if we think about these vertical lines, these two lines are a part of smaller cylinder and these two lines are a part of larger cylinder. So these lines are parallel to the z axis. That is why while we move from this corner to this corner, this corner to this corner, this corner to this corner, similarly here, we have the change along z axis. The change can be denoted by dz. So dz is actually z2 minus z1. So this is same as we have seen in the case of rectangular coordinate system. Now the new thing is that this dimension, this change and this change. This is not a straight line, it is the arc. Okay. Now, in cylindrical coordinate system, the point is represented with the coordinates rho, I and z. For rho, we have seen the representation. For z, we have seen the representation. Now, the change into angle phi, that is denoted by these arcs. According to the definition of phi, phi is the angle made by the radius segment with the positive x direction. So if this is the positive x direction taken at the perpendicular intersection with the z axis, so that time this corner has this radius, suppose this angle is phi 1. This corner has this radius, the radius value is same but the angle value is different, suppose this phi 2. So in general, we would write d phi is equal to phi 2 minus phi 1. But if you see these two corners case and these two corner case, this corner has this much of radius with the angle phi 2. This corner has some bigger radius, okay, but the same angle phi 2. This corner has the smaller radius with the angle phi 1, whereas this corner has some bigger radius, let us say rho 2, with the same angle phi 1. So this r also gives us phi 2 minus phi 1. This r also gives us phi 2 minus phi 1, but in fact this r has smaller magnitude as compared to this one. So we can notice that as the radius is increasing, the arc length is also increasing. So it is not sufficient for this dimension to be written simply d phi. We have to multiply it with the radius of the cylinder also. So this will be rho into d phi. So in general, for the differential length, we shall be writing d rho, okay, then rho d phi and dz. The unit vectors are d rho will have the increase in a rho cap direction. The d phi, rho d phi more specifically, it will have increase in a phi cap direction, plus, this is plus, dz will have the changes in a z cap direction. So the differential length for a cylindrical coordinate system will be denoted as d rho a rho cap, rho d phi a phi cap, plus dz a z cap, and the unit will be in terms of meter cube. So this was differential length for a cylindrical coordinate system. So we have seen the differential length representation using the rules of cylindrical coordinate system. Now let us begin with the representation of differential surfaces in the rules of cylindrical coordinate system. Now the object what we have drawn is here. So in differential length, these sides we had represented by d rho, the vertical edges we had represented by dz, and the arc lengths we had represented by rho d phi. Now this object also has six surfaces, so correspondingly I will write ds1, ds2, ds3, ds4, ds5 and ds6 for the six surfaces. The magnitudes will be determined by the multiplication of two dimensions forming that particular surface. So let us designate ds1 to the top surface. The top surface is formed by these two edges in opposite side and these two edges. So this edge is nothing but d rho, and this dimension is nothing but rho d phi. So we get the magnitude of the top surface by the multiplication of d rho into rho d phi. So more conventionally, convenience, I write rho d rho d phi. Okay. So the magnitude is given like this. Now for the bottom wall, we have these sides. So again, d rho rho d phi. So it will be rho d rho d phi. For, I say this is the back side of this particular and this is the front side. So this is formed by dz and rho d phi. So we write rho d phi first of all, then dz. The front side also formed by the same rho d phi and dz. Now this side wall is by the multiplication of d rho with dz. So I write d rho dz, and the remaining side wall by d rho and dz. So these are the magnitudes of the differential surfaces. Okay. So we have to give them the directions. The ds1 was rho d phi. Similarly, ds2 rho d rho d phi. ds3 it was rho d phi dz. ds4 again the same. Here the opposite walls have same magnitude of surface area. As we have discussed in the case of rectangular coordinate system also, that for differential surfaces they have particular direction, and for the surface the direction is perpendicular or normal to that particular surface. For the top, the two options are either to go up or down. For the bottom, again two options, either to go up or down. So for the object, we have to select that particular direction which will take you out of this object. The reason is, in electromagnetic field theory, for electric field or magnetic field, we have certain source because of which the existence of electric field and magnetic field is there. So for the positive magnitude of charge, which is the source of electric field, we always know that the flux come out of that place. So from the object, we take the outward direction. So for the top, upward direction will be the outward. So this is aligned to the positive z direction. That is why we take the unit vector az cap. For the bottom, we take minus az cap, which goes towards the minus z axis, negative side of z axis. From this side wall, we take increasing direction of radius. So this is a rho cap. For this particular side wall, we take decreasing direction of radius, that is minus a rho cap. For this one, we take decreasing direction of a phi cap minus, and for the remaining one formed by dz and d rho, it will be increasing direction of angle phi. Okay, so here we can give the unit vectors az cap for the top wall, minus az cap for the bottom wall. So I put the bar over here. Here rho d phi and dz. So rho d phi and dz. So for this particular wall, it was a rho. For the opposite, on the backward side, it was minus a rho cap. And for the remaining two side walls, this was, for this particular side wall, this was minus a phi cap, decreasing direction of the angle phi, measurement of angle phi, and this is associated with a phi cap. So I put bar over each and every differential surface here. So in general, the differential surface representation for the object we discussed having the sample or differential amount of three-dimensional space in the rules of cylindrical coordinate systems, we have the generalized representation as follows. So ds bar will be the addition of rho d phi az cap plus rho d phi minus az cap plus rho d phi dz a rho cap plus rho d phi dz minus a rho cap. Opposite sides have opposite unit vectors, d rho dz minus a phi cap plus d rho dz to a phi cap. The six surfaces have been added here. So this is the net differential surface for the object we considered for analysis purpose. As this is differential surface, the unit will be meter square, or the area meter square. So we have seen the differential surface. Now it's time to find the differential volume for cylindrical coordinate system representation. The object under analysis was like this. it was having two types of edges, the straight lines, and one the arc length. So this arc length we have denoted by rho d phi, the vertical edge by dz, and this type of edge by d rho. So now we know that differential volume is the multiplication of all the three dimensions, length, breadth into height. So that is why we have to multiply all the three dimensions here. So we take d rho, then dz, and this arc length rho d phi. So writing into a proper sequence, as we take rho phi z, so we take rho first of all, it will be rho d phi and dz. So this will be the differential volume for the cylindrical coordinate system representation, and it is volume, that is why the meter cube will be the unit added to it. So now we have gone through the differential length, differential surface, and differential volume for rectangular as well as for cylindrical coordinate system representation. Let us have differential length, differential surface, and differential volumes for the spherical coordinate system representation. So for analysis purpose, I have drawn a sample three-dimensional space outside for analysis purpose. As we know that in the case of spherical coordinate system, the reference is a point. In the rectangular coordinate system, the reference with which we make the measurements are x, y, and z axis. In cylindrical coordinate system, we have only one axis, that is z. In spherical coordinate system, we have only one point, that is origin. So suppose in this diagram, the origin is situated here. So if this is origin O, so the orientations, just for imagination purpose, or the z axis will be this way, the y axis this way, and x axis this way. So this is z, x, y. Now this object also has 8 corners, 1, 2, 3, 4. The group of these 4 corners, you can imagine, is a part of smaller sphere centered at origin, whereas the group of these 4 corners form a bigger sphere. Okay, so this surface is a part of smaller sphere, this surface is a part of bigger sphere. So now when we have our attention to the edges which join these two corners and these two corners, we are in the increasing direction of the radius of the sphere. In another words, I can say that we are switching from smaller sphere to bigger sphere. Let us say the smaller sphere is having the radius r1 and the bigger sphere is having the radius r2. So if you take r2 minus r1, this will be the length of this particular side that we denote here by dr. So dr is in general r2 minus r1. So these 4 edges now we are going to denote by dr. Now this arc, that are common as we switch from cylindrical coordinate system to spherical coordinate system. Okay. Why? Because these arcs have the corners or the end points which make the difference into the angle phi. For more clarification, I redraw it here. And let us join these corners. So if we say this is the origin and this is the z axis. So let us take this corner and this corner. As we know that phi is the angle made by a perpendicular drop onto the z-axis which acts as a radius rho in case of cylindrical coordinate system with the positive direction of x-axis. So from this corner, I drop a perpendicular onto the z-axis. Let us say it intersects z-axis here. From this corner also, the intersection of the perpendicular segment will be at the same point. So these two points are at same height, as this is z-axis and this is origin O. So at this intersection point, we take the direction parallel to that of positive x direction. Okay. So for this corner, let us say this is phi 1 angle, and for this corner, this is phi 2 angle. Phi 2 is greater than phi 1. That is why for this much of arc length, as we have done earlier in the cylindrical coordinate system, the difference is of phi 2 minus phi 1, we generally denote d phi. Okay. So this arc should be d phi. But what was the thing? As the radius of the cylinder was increased, the arc length was also increased. So we talk radius in case of cylindrical coordinate system, which is actually a perpendicular drop from the point on the z-axis, which acts as rho, and we call that radius of that particular cylinder. So these are two corners have, let us say, rho 2 radius. These two have same length, and these two corners have, let us draw perpendicular onto the z-axis, rho 1 radius. So as rho has been increased as compared to this arc length is more. That is why we have to multiply it with rho. So this kind of dimension in our object, we will write rho into d. Okay. Now, as we switch from this corner to this corner, this to this, we have already seen that I have to represent the change of r, r2 minus r1, that is why dr. Okay. Now, one more arc length is introduced in this diagram. Now, these arcs are aligned to the direction with which we measure the angle theta. As we are in the spherical coordinate system dimension, the point P is represented using r, theta and phi. So for r, the changes we have noticed by dr. For the phi, we have made the notice of changes by rho into d phi. And for theta, we see that theta by the definition is the angle made by radius r segment of the sphere with the positive z direction. So theta is by definition angle made by the radius segment r with the positive z direction. So in this diagram, if I take this corner, so I have to join it to the origin directly. So this one, suppose r1 is there, radius of smaller sphere. So the angle made by this radius segment with the axis positive z. So this is theta 1. Now this theta 1 is common for this one also, this one also, this one also. Okay. Now for this corner, I have to join it with the origin. So it drops angle, I write here theta 2. Okay. So as compared to this angle is having more value. Okay. So I can say theta 2 minus theta 1, we can represent d theta. So this kind of arc length, what we have for the object under analysis, okay, we should be writing d theta. But we have seen that as we switch from the portion of smaller sphere to the bigger sphere, this arc length is same as they are from smaller sphere. But this arc length and this arc length, this one is large. Why? Because we have switched from smaller sphere to the bigger sphere. So there is the role of parameter r. So we should not write simply it to be the d theta. We should write d theta multiplied by r. So this dimension is r d theta. This dimension is rho d phi. This dimension is dr. Now, one more thing is to be noticed that we are in the domain of spherical coordinate system. The spherical coordinate systems are denoted by r theta phi. There is no rho here. So, as we have seen, the transformation from cylindrical coordinate system to spherical coordinate system, we have to make the substitution in terms of r theta phi. And we have known, we have already derived that r is equal to, rho is equal to r sin theta. That is why instead of representing it rho d phi, we shall be representing it r sin theta d phi. Okay. Now for more clarification, I redraw the same. Please consider the symmetry. So here, these are dr. These ones we just saw. So these are r d theta, and these types of arcs are rho d phi, which are equal to r sin theta d phi. Okay. So 1, 2, 3 and 4, these are dr. 1, 2, 3, 4, these are r d theta, and 1, 2, 3, 4, these are r sin theta d phi. So the differential lengths here we can represent in general. DL is equal to the component of dr plus the component of theta, that is r d theta, plus the component of phi, that is r sin theta d phi. So as the differential length is a vector, I have to put the unit vectors here. So dr is associated with ar cap, increasing direction of the radius of sphere. R d theta, we take increasing direction of theta, so it will be associated with a theta cap. And for the third term, I have to put here a phi cap. So this is the generalized differential length representation in spherical coordinate system. As it is a measure of length, distance, I put the unit meters here. So now let us talk about the differential surfaces into spherical coordinate system for the same kind of object. So now we again see it has six surfaces. We cannot directly say top, bottom and sidewalls. It is quite hard to imagine, but simple. So the let us say this is the first surface. So for this first surface, I write ds1. Opposite to that one, let us say ds2. This one we shall write ds3. Opposite to that one, that is formed by this one, we shall write ds4. This surface in my side, I write ds5, and on the back side I can say ds6. We will repeat this one. So now the ds1 is formed by these pair of arcs and these pair of arcs. So we have to multiply r d theta with r sin theta d phi. So it becomes r square sin theta d theta d phi. Okay. So the magnitude for ds2 will also be the same. The magnitude for ds3 is formed by a pair of arc length and this dimension. So ds3 will be, this arc is r sin theta d phi. R dr I write sin theta r dr sin theta and d phi. For the opposite, that is ds4, it will be the same. For the ds5, this is the arc length, that is r d theta and this sine. So here we write r dr d theta. So it will be the same for the ds6 also. So here the differential surface representation, we have just mentioned the magnitudes by multiplication of the two edges forming that particular surface. Okay. Let us give the direction also. So I write it in more details. Ds1 is r square sin theta d theta d phi. Ds2 is also having the same magnitude, r square sin theta d phi. Ds3 is having r dr sin theta d phi. Ds4 r dr sin theta d phi. Ds5 having r dr d theta. Ds6 also r dr d theta. So now we shall be putting the bar over here once we assign the unit vector. So for the surface, the direction with which we represent the unit vector should be perpendicular to that particular surface. So for the ds1, we have r square sin theta d phi. So first surface is this one. So if you take perpendicular to this, so it will be either directed away like this or in the reverse direction. So this direction is increasing the direction, increasing the radius of the sphere. This direction, we have switched from lower sphere to the bigger sphere. So we have determined the magnitudes of differential surfaces in spherical coordinate system. We have to give the direction. So for ds1, the direction by a particular unit vector we have to give. So the object we take here, so ds1 is for this surface formed by pair of arcs. So we have to select the outward direction this way. So if this is origin O, so this shall be in the increasing direction of radius, that is ar cap. So I put ar cap here. For ds2, ds2 we have considered this surface. So this is opposite to that one. So the direction will be the reversed one. So I shall put here minus ar cap. You can see that if the differentials d theta and d phi are there, the parameters are r theta and phi. The parameter which is not taken into consideration, okay, that left parameter, you can give the direction also. So here there is no r, only the theta and phi are present. That is why I put ar cap. Similarly, for ds3, it is formed by dr r sin theta d phi. The dr and r sin theta d phi. So it means this is the particular surface. So the direction will be outward like this. So at the origin, we measure theta in this direction. This is away to that particular. So I shall be putting here minus a theta cap. Now for this particular surface, this will be the direction, that is with the direction of measurement of angle theta. So I shall be giving you a theta cap as the vector for this ds4. So I put bar over here after putting the unit vectors. Ds5 and ds6, that are r dr d theta. So dr we have, r d theta we have. So this is this particular surface. So this is coming towards me. So it is in the decreasing direction of measurement of angle theta, angle phi. So phi we measure in this direction, we are coming in the reverse direction. That is why for ds5 I put minus a phi cap, and for ds6 I put a phi cap. So now these are the six differential surfaces associated with the object we have taken for analyzing the differential surfaces in the rectangular coordinate system. The net differential surface, what we say, ds bar will be the addition of ds1 bar plus ds2, ds3 plus ds4 plus ds5 and ds6. Okay, the unit of measurement will be in terms of square meter or meter square. Now what about the differential volume? So for differential volume we have to multiply all the three dimensions. So dv we take, it will be the multiplication of dr, it will be the multiplication with r d theta and r sin theta d phi. So it will be in sequence r dr sin theta d theta d phi. So we have determined the magnitude of differential volume for spherical coordinate system object. So as this is differential volume, the unit should be given meter cube. So this is dv for spherical coordinate system. So this way we have covered the differential lengths, differential surfaces and differential volume related to the three coordinate systems: cylindrical, rectangular and spherical coordinate system. Now in the next lecture we will see the del operator with some vector operations, and finally in the miscellaneous we will solve some problems based on to all these concepts. Thank you.